Jonathan Romero right here. When I first met him, you know, he was Abel's cousin, by the way. Our brother Abel was you can just sense that this guy wanted a change in his life.
Yeah.
And so, bro, I'm super proud of you. I'm encouraged to see how you've just gone after the scriptures and really applied them to make those changes. So I love you a lot. And at this time, we're going to allow a couple brothers share about our soon-to-be brother, Jonathan.
Well, when I first met Jonathan, what really impressed me was that he said at the time when he was seeking God, he was in Mexico when Mexico had that earthquake. So when he got back over, he just started to reflect on his couple years back when, because he studied Bible before with Manny. And so when he started studying the Bible, so he started making some life changes that had prevented him before from being baptized. So fast forward to here, he has been persevering through those challenges, and like these challenges that we represent put towards him also, he had overcome. He also was eagerly seeking God because like he'll ask us questions after questions after questions, even questions that weren't even on the studies. So he challenged us also with some of his questions. So I look forward to baptizing him today and adding him to our to our community.
I want to encourage you, bro, with the scripture in Matthew 6. Says, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. And I know our family, we can definitely worry a lot. I know you've been going through a lot, just with life itself. But, I just want to tell you, I love you, man. It's the beginning right now. Well, right now, right? And, I just love you a lot.
Come on, primo.
I can't wait to call you my brother.
I walked in here actually full of fear, and before this, I've had a lot of fear in my life, and I just want to start with the scripture in Isaiah 59, 1 through 2, and it's just basically, listen, the Lord's arm is not too weak to save you, nor his ears too deaf to hear you call. It's your sins that have cut you off from God. Because of your sins, he has turned away and will not listen anymore. This is something I struggle with because I've always wondered why I kept falling. And even though I've heard the Lord's word, every day it was just like I'm battling something that I knew I couldn't do alone. And I've always known God, but and accepted Jesus into my heart, but I've always questioned myself, like, there has to be more to this.
Yeah,
I've soon realized that it was my wall of sin that had blocked my connection with God.
Yeah.
And I give glory to the Lord for answering my prayer to lead me in this direction, and as a result, it is leading me to a church of brothers and sisters who seek him wholeheartedly.
Come on.
So that was my problem, is I wasn't seeking him wholeheartedly. Yeah. I've always had one foot in the world and one foot with God, but then I realized that it doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
And, you're either in the lightness or in the darkness. So I was in pure darkness. I was listening to God's word, but I had no action. And that just shows that my heart was not right with God. I was fooling myself every day, and now I know what God's full purpose was. And that was to turn away from my old life, to repent, getting baptized, most importantly, going out and making other disciples. Yeah. I give thanks to the Most High also because he sent me to disciple, because I've asked for this, I've been seeking for this, and I just totally thankful for the Lord for doing that, because he totally answered my prayer, and just my great amazing men and disciples that are like challenging from falling, and every day, I mean, it's been an amazing 3 weeks, but at the same time, it was very tough. But I just want to thank every one of you guys, because you put in time out and you're doing it to seek to save me, and I just appreciate that. So thank you.
Did you believe Jesus is the Son of God? Lived a sinless life. He died on the cross for your sins and resurrected on the third day.
Amen. Definitely, I do. That Jesus is Lord.
Fingers. Go again. Let's go again. There you go.
There you go.